Hello students, in today's lecture we will discuss about urbanization and crime. Firstly, we should understand the term urbanization. Urbanization is a process which refers to the proportion of population living in urban areas of a country. Urbanization is often used more loosely, however, to refer to a broad-based rural to urban transition involving population, land use, economic activity and culture, or indeed any one of these. Now the question arises, what do we mean by urban areas? There is no standard definition of an urban area. It varies from country to country. Insertion 1 shows the criteria of delimiting an urban area that can be based on the size of population, density of population, types of activity, administrative functioning bodies of urban characteristics other than mentioned before. Different countries in the world use different criteria to demarcate an urban area as shown in insertion 2. In Canada, an area having a population of more than 1000 persons is classified as an urban settlement, while in the United States, places having 2500 or more persons are classified as urban places. In Israel, all the settlements having population of 2000 persons and 2/3 of the workers engaged in non-agricultural sector qualify as an urban area. In Spain, it includes municipios of 10,000 or more persons. In Belgium, communes of 5,000 or more persons. In Denmark, an agglomeration of 200 or more persons. While in Japan, urban municipalities usually having 30,000 or more persons. It shows that size of population varies from country to country while demarcating an urban area. United Kingdom, a settlement is considered as urban on the basis of local government such as county boroughs, municipal boroughs and urban districts. Nepal defines urban areas on the basis of population size only. On the other hand, countries such as Bangladesh, Sri Lanka and Pakistan apply only the specific status criterion to declare a settlement as urban. In India, all statutory towns, that is all places with a municipal corporation, cantonment board or notified area committees, etc. as urban. In addition to these, those areas are also termed urban which have firstly a minimum population of 5000 persons, secondly 75% of their male working population engaged in non-agricultural activities, and thirdly a density of population of at least 400 persons per square kilometer. When we are discussing the process of urbanization, then it is also important to understand the term urbanism. Sometimes students use urbanism as synonym to urbanization. Urbanization refers to the proportion of people living in an urban area. However, urbanism refers to the way of lifestyle by which a section of population adopts an urban way of life even while residing in the countryside. Now we will see the scenario of urbanization on the global level, which is shown in insertion 3. According to the United Nations, presently 54% of the world population is living in urban areas, making present century an urban century. The most urbanized regions of the world include Northern America 82%, Latin America and Caribbean islands 80%, and Europe 73%. In contrast, the developing continents of Africa and Asia remain mostly rural. Only 40% and 48% of their respective population living in urban areas. In the terms of level of urbanization, Asia and Africa are one century behind America and Europe. It is projected that Asia and Africa will attain the same proportion of urban population in 2050, where the developed countries like American and European countries were in the decade of 1950s. It is significant to note that in 2014, majority of the megacities of the world are located in Asia and Africa. In the urban map of 2014, you can also observe many megacities of the world such as Delhi, Mumbai, London, Paris, Shanghai, Beijing, Tokyo, Kinshasa and Laos are in Asia and Africa. Urbanization has become the reality of the present world and it is bound to rise in the future. Insertion 4 shows that in 90s, North America reported 75% of its population living in urban areas, followed by Latin America and Oceania with 71%, Europe with 70%, Asia with 32% and Africa with 31%. In a span of nearly 24 years, the rate of urbanization remained low in North America, Latin America, Europe and Oceania. The big change was experienced in Asia and Africa. In this period, from 32% to 48% and from 31% to 40% respectively. In this highly urbanizing scenario prevalent in the world, the crime and its related activities are bound to increase their area as well as their impact. Therefore, it becomes important to analyze the relationship between urbanization and crime. Now, let us understand the meaning of crime. Crimes are usually defined as acts forbidden by law that can be punished by imprisonment or fine. In the present urbanizing world, crime has emerged as one of the most serious problems related with urbanization. Urbanization and crime is interrelated. Urbanization creates many processes to occur crime. On the other hand, crime creates many problems in the city life. Sociologists such as Emil Durkheim, 1897, and Max Weber, 1958, wrote about the changes that occurred as a result of the transition of societies from agrarian and village-based forms to industrialized and urban-based ones. They proposed that during rapid social change, growing and expanding cities would be hotbeds of crime. Urban crimes shown in insertion 5 include murder, rape, kidnapping and abduction, cheating, robberies and theft, pickpocketing, etc. After knowing the different types of crimes, it is important to discuss the major reasons of increasing crimes in the cities, which are shown in insertion 6. These are the growing materialism, consumerism, competition in everyday life, selfishness, lavishness, appalling socio-economic disparities, rising unemployment and feeling of loneliness in the crowd, etc. Not only the poor, deprived and slum dwellers take to crime, but the youngsters from well-to-do families also resort to crime in order to make fast money for meeting requirements of a lavish life. Insertion 7 provides an overview of urbanization and crime in the world. The Richest magazine identified the most dangerous cities in the world in 2015, out of which some are shown on the map. Number 1 is San Pedro Sula, is considered the most dangerous city in the most dangerous country in the world. In 2014, the murder rate was as high as 171 deaths per lakh persons. The city suffers from drug trafficking, illegal arms trafficking, gang warfare and countless murders. Number 2 is Acapulco, which has been a luxury coastal destination for celebrities and high profile sporting events for years. But in the recent years, Acapulco has consistently registered the highest murder rate for a Mexican city. In 2014, the murder rate was shocking, 104 murders per lakh persons. The third city is Caracas, which is known for three things: being the capital of Venezuela, murders and drugs. Caracas has a population of about 3.5 million and the crimes such as robberies, murders, rapes and kidnapping are rampant. Next is Kabul, the capital of Islamic Republic of Afghanistan, that has become one of the most dangerous cities in the world for nearly a decade. The city has economic and political instability and suffers from severe poverty, which leads to kidnapping, homicide, terrorist bombing, constant power struggle, violence and other petty crimes. At number 5 is Guatemala, a beautiful city in Central America, which has a serious drug and crime problem. Guatemala borders Mexico, Honduras and El Salvador. Therefore, drugs related crimes are common. In addition to this, a large disparity between socioeconomic classes, severe poverty and an overabundance of guns has ruined the crime scene. Guatemala City is a haven for drug fueled crimes, robberies, assaults, kidnappings and carjackings. The city also has one of the highest violent crime rates in Central America, with about 42 murders per lakh persons. Next comes Cape Town in South Africa. Despite being one of the most beautiful places to visit in the world, is also one of the most dangerous cities. Cape Town has a population of 3.75 million only, and the city has a high crime rate of 50.94 murders per lakh persons. Cape Town also has the Dubuque's distinction of being the most violent city on the continent. The main reasons are the socio-economic disparity between classes giving rise to gang warfare, murders, robberies, rapes and kidnappings, etc. Seventh city is Rio de Janeiro of Brazil, which is also known as the mugging capital of the world. Street crimes, robberies and murders are quite common in the city. Baghdad is one of the eight slot. Ever since the US invaded Baghdad, the city has got a reputation of being one of the most dangerous place in the world. For years, bombing, bullets and murders are common in the city. The years of constant warfare has virtually destroyed the city's infrastructure and economy has collapsed. The war-torn city has been struggling to survive and random acts of crime and terrorism continue to occur. Next city is Ciudad Juarez in Mexico, has an unpleasant reputation of being a drug and traffic haven. It is also called the murder capital of the world. The city is an extremely dangerous and lawless place, where drug related crimes, violence and murders are common. After Ciudad de Juarez comes Mogadishu, the capital city of Somalia, which is one of the most dangerous city in the world. The city is the home of an ongoing brutal civil war and it suffers from corruption, poverty, crime, violence and bombing. Mogadishu is followed by Karachi, the provincial capital of Sindh, is rife with political instability and hostile conflicts between foreign and indigenous terrorist groups. The city also reports a large number of robberies, kidnapping, terrorism, assassination and murders on a daily basis. Sana'a in Yemen is also one of the most dangerous places to live in the world. The city suffers from political instability. Since 2012, the living standards has deteriorated and crime rates has increased. Constant bombings, assassinations and random acts of terrorism are mixed with everyday robberies, murders and other small petty crimes. The United States of America is one of the most developed countries in the world. However, the crime rate is also high in the country. The city of Detroit in Texas state has been named America's most dangerous city in 2013 and 14. The city has a population nearly 7 lakh and has a staggering violent crime rate of 2072 per lakh persons and a murder rate of 45 homicide per lakh population. Another dangerous city is San Salvador, which is in the capital of El Salvador, a tiny country in Central America. The city has a population of only about 570,000 persons and a homicide rate of 45 persons per lakh population. Violence is like second nature in the city and civilians are usually caught in crossfire of these constant gang wars. Not only this, robberies and extortions are also common in the city. On the last comes Cali. Cali is one of the most dangerous cities in Colombia. The city has the dominance of drug trafficking cartels and witnessed the presence of corrupt guerrilla groups and registered a homicide rate of 83 per lakh persons. After discussing the most dangerous cities of the world, we will try to understand the crime scenario in the big cities of the world. Insertion 8 shows that according to United Nations World Urbanization Prospects 2014, the big cities of the world are Tokyo, Delhi, Shanghai, Mumbai, Beijing, Dhaka, Karachi, Al Qahira, Lagos, Ciudad de Mexico, Sao Paulo, Osaka, and New York. These cities are not only the biggest cities of 2014 only, but most of these cities are also projected to witness an unprecedented increase in their population and expand by 2030. Thus, it becomes important to understand the crime scenario in these big cities of the world. Surprisingly, these cities show varying pattern in reporting crime. Insertion 9 brings out the fact that Tokyo, the biggest city of the world, is also one of the safest cities as it reports very low crime rate. Accompanying it, Osaka, another mega city of Japan, also has a very low crime rate. It can be mainly because going to prison is considered a major social stigma in Japan. The high conviction rate and flexibility of law in China is a major reason of low crime rate in Shanghai and Beijing. Mumbai, the financial capital of India, reports a medium crime rate. Except the previously discussed mega cities, all the other cities such as Delhi, Dhaka, Al Qahira, Lagos and Ciudad de Mexico observe high crime rates in 2015. Among the mega cities of the world, Karachi in Pakistan, Sao Paulo in Brazil are also considered as the dangerous cities of the world. After the discussion on urbanization and crime in the world, it is important to understand the urbanization and crime scenario in India. Firstly, we will understand the status of urbanization in India from insertion 10. According to 2011 census, the urban population grew to 37 crore in 2011 from 28 crore in 2001. The population in urban areas of India increased at the rate of 2.6% per annum during 2001-2011. For the first time since independence, the absolute increase in population is more in urban areas than in rural areas. The level of urbanization in India as a whole increased gradually after independence. Insertion 11 shows that in 1951, only 17.29% of the population lived in urban areas, which increased to 17.97% in 1961 and 19.91% in 1971. It became 23.34% in 1981, 25.71% in 1991, 27.81% in 2001 and 31.16% in 2011. Insertion 12 shows the map of India's urbanization in 2011, that Maharashtra, Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Kerala, Punjab, National Capital Territory of Delhi and Mizoram have more than 35% of their population living in urban areas. It shows that the southern states have more urbanization than the northern states. with the only exceptions of Punjab and National Capital Territory of Delhi. In the last, we will discuss the crime scenario in the megacities of India. The megacities face increased criminal activities because of a number of socio-economic factors such as poverty, increase in unemployment rate, drug abuse, etc. These cities have become hotbeds of crime. In 2014, as many as 18,43,862 cognizable crimes were reported in these 53 megacities. The megacities observed a crime rate of 1147.3% as compared to the crime rate of 581.1% at all in India, which is much higher than the national average. It becomes evident from the graph in insertion 13 that more than 30% of crimes such as theft, robbery, cheating, attempt to murder are reported in megacities only, while the percentage of rape, kidnapping and abduction, criminal breach of trust, counterfeiting, forgery, incidents of rash driving accounts for more than 20% in these mega cities. A sneak peek into the different crimes and their status reported in the year 2014 are shown in the insertion 14. Delhi is not only the administrative capital of India, but it is also known as the criminal capital of the nation. Delhi tops all the megacities in reporting grievous crimes such as murder, attempt to murder, culpable homicide not amounting to murder, attempt to commit culpable homicide, kidnapping and abduction, robbery, criminal trespass, causing death by negligence, etc. Delhi also ranks high among the cities having high rate of women related crimes such as rape, cruelty by husband or his relatives, assault as well as insult to women's modesty, etc. Mumbai city records more of the finance related crimes such as criminal breach of trust and forgery, etc. Whereas the cities like Pune, Patna and Jaipur suffers from high incidence of dacoity, cheating and riots. Conclusion. Thus, it can be concluded from the discussion that urbanization and crime has a complex relationship. Urbanization and crime is not related only with the developing countries, but the cities of developed countries of the world are home of the different types of crimes. San Pedro Sula, Honduras, Acapulco, Mexico, Caracas, Venezuela, Kabul, Afghanistan, Guatemala City, Guatemala, Cape Town, South Africa, Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, Baghdad, Iraq, Ciudad Juarez, Mexico, Mogadishu, Somalia, Santae, Yemen, Detroit, USA, Karachi, Pakistan, San Salvador, El Salvador and Cali, Colombia are some of the most dangerous cities of the world. Out of the major cities of the world, only Tokyo, Osaka and Shanghai are considered safe cities to live, but other cities such as Delhi, Mumbai, Dhaka, Karachi, Lagos and Sao Paulo are notorious for criminal activities. In developing countries like India, where urbanization is happening at fast pace, the incidence of crime are also high. Delhi, the capital of the nation, is also the criminal capital of India, as the city reports high rate of almost all types of crimes, such as robberies, thefts, rapes, kidnapping and abduction, etc. Thus, it becomes clear from the above discussion that crime in cities is not quite rampant. It is not positively related to the level of urbanization only, but other socio-economic and institutional factors also determine its growth at a particular place. Thank you very much. We'll be right back.